In this video, I will be going over how to download Gamejolt games manually for Windows. You can find timestamps, links, and a written transcription will be in the description box below. Alright, let's get started by heading over to Gamejolt.com. Once there, select a game that you are interested in playing either by searching in the top bar for a specific game, browsing the different tags, or browse all games from the front page. After finding the game or games you want to download, select it, and you will be taken to the author's page. From here, click on the download button and a Windows Explorer will pop up. You can choose to rename the game if you wish and save it anywhere you prefer on your computer. For this video, I am going to save it to my desktop, so I'll hit save at the bottom right of the window. Now, if you don't have the Windows Explorer pop-up, try another browser. I'll have some links to a few browsers that you can check out in case it doesn't work with the one you are using right now. Once that is downloaded, we will need a program to unpack the game you downloaded. Otherwise, trying to open certain games with the .rar extension will result in an error. I prefer using 7-Zip. It's an unpacking program I have used for years, and it's pretty simple to set up, free, and safe to use. Let's head over to 7-Zip.org, and you will want to select one of these two options at the top of the page, depending on your Windows operating system. To find out which Windows you are running, right-click on your Windows icon on your desktop at the bottom left here, and then choose System. On the About page, you can view your system type, which will tell you if you are running 32-bit Windows or 64-bit. Now we can pick the one that was found, so for me it will be the second link since I am on 64-bit. Same as the game, you can save this program anywhere. Let's continue with the same location from before to make it easier. After it is finished downloading, then we can run the program. You may have the user account control window come up asking if you want to run the program. Select yes. Okay, we are almost done with setting this up. The destination folder will be where 7-Zip is installed. It should default to your C drive, so let's install it here. Now that it is installed, we can go back to where we downloaded our Gamejolt game and right-click on it. Move to Open With, choose Another App, More Apps. Click on 7-Zip File Manager, then make sure to checkmark this box. Always use this app to open .zip files, or if you downloaded a .rar game while watching this, it will say always use this app to open .rar files. Press OK and the games you downloaded should have 7-Zip logos on them, although they don't always appear, so we'll want to right click on your desktop. So let's right click and select refresh, and now you should be able to see them wherever you downloaded your games. We made it this far. Now comes the final part, using 7-Zip to extract. Double click on the game that you downloaded and a 7-Zip window will now pop up. You will see a folder which you can drag to anywhere on your computer. For me, I will put it here on the desktop just to make things easier. It will take a second or minute to extract depending on the game and your computer speed. Once it is done, you can open up the folder and then select the .exe app to run the game. That's all there is to it. Hopefully this has helped you with getting your games to work using the manual method. If you have any questions or issues, then post them in the comments below. You can also contact Gamejolt support here at contact@gamejolt.com. I'll have a video on how to set up and install Gamejolt from the client app. You'll be able to find it here once it is uploaded, and also I'll have it in the description with the rest of the links covered in this video. As always, everyone, if this video was helpful to you, feel free to subscribe to the channel. Until next time, take care.